Good morning, everyone. This is Tejashwini Sahu from BJEMS School 2, and today I'm going to speak on implementation of science and technology in our daily life. Science and technology is important because it influences most aspects of everyday life, including food, energy, shelter, medicines, transportations, communications, etc. Everything in our world today is the gift of science and technology. All the things around us is just possible of these factors. Science improves human life at every level, from individual efforts to global issues. Whereas technology plays major role in making our life comfortable, easy, simpler and faster. Edward Taylor tells that science of today is the technology of tomorrow. Science and technology has combined in such a manner that they provide miracles in our life. Basically, we can say that science and technology acts like a platform for better lifestyle. Science and technology has helped us in different situations, starting from natural calamities and disasters. This science and technologies has also helped in development of nuclear technologies, meteorological science, space science, wireless communications, nanotechnologies, etc. The mobile phones that we use today are only possible because of this technology. The role of science and technology is indispensable. We need science and technology in every sphere of our life. In fact, without science and technology, we cannot imagine our life. Work can be done easier through high-tech machines and equipments. It gives less work for humans and jobs can be done faster. It also provides a comfortable and easy way to live our life. New research technologies are in a continuous process and researchers have explored new topics for investigations such as renewable resources, environmental factors, space science, electronics, stem cell investigations, etc. Science and technology has also helped to reveal this COVID-19 situation. Although we all know we students are reading in the virtual mode, which implements better understandings in this good platform. Because of the presence of the science and technologies, the scientists could trace the corona positive people and successfully treated them by tests, treatments and other strategies, ensuring the timing and supply of medicines and good hospital facilities. We all know in this virtual platform, we all are reading different type of things. We all know internet has provided a very good access to all the students. The implementation of science and technology includes in educational field. Through radios, televisions, internets, mobile phones, students can learn everything going on in the world. Science and technologies also play a crucial role in the agricultural sector. In the agricultural sector, people and farmers can interlink with each other and the scientists can also make their projects on the fields with the help of the farmers. They can get easy, good manures and fertilizers even. The e-commerce and the trade is also working well because of the science and technology. The connectivity in the cities and towns and in the online interactive sections are also being improved by this e-commerce industries. The e-governance sector is also working well because of these technologies. The politics and the politicians can easily talk with the public and implement their rules and regulation in virtual platform events. That improves the transparency in the government also. Although we all know it plays a very crucial role in the healthcare sector even. In the healthcare sector, it provides all the facilities, new machines and tests. In previously, people used to move to different hospitals for checking their blood sugar levels. But now, by sitting at home only, we can check our blood sugar level and any other things. The infrastructure development is also possible because of the science and technologies that is developing the bridge constructions, construction of malls, road constructions, etc. So, I would like to conclude that science and technology play a vital role in our daily life. And also, the technology that I had implemented in my project, the uses of the sensors also proves this factor that science and technology means a huge lot thing to everyone. With this, I sign off. Thank you.
Hello everyone, this is Tejashini Sahu from BJMS School 2 and today I am here with my model that is Pauli Ejector and Trash Segregator. Earth is the only planet in the universe which sustains human life. It is very important that we take this factor as a concern and take very good care of our environment and our resources. Various human activities has led to the destruction of quality of air and hence has caused air pollution. Human beings can live a few days without food and water, but humans cannot survive a few seconds without oxygen. So it is very much necessary to have a clean and a hygienful life. So we are here with a solution for that is Pauli Ejector and Trash Segregator. Basically in India, we use two type of dustbin, that is biodegradable and non-biodegradable dustbin. But unfortunately, we are unable to utilize these dustbins in a proper manner. So this model will be guiding the people of India about the utilization of green and blue dustbin in a perfect manner. Now moving on to the methodology of Pauli Ejector. Pauli Ejector means separation of plastic. Now let's put any biodegradable substance to this biodegradable bin, then it will be accepting that type of waste. But if we put any type of non-biodegradable waste in this biodegradable bin, then it will send a message to MCU and MCU will send a message to LCD. LCD will display a message as don't throw biodegradable waste here. So that the person can understand not to throw biodegradable waste in this biodegradable dustbin. Now, when we put any type of biodegradable waste in this non-biodegradable dustbin, then it will send a message to MCU and MCU will send a message to LCD, whereas LCD will display a message as don't throw biodegradable waste here, so that the person can understand not to throw biodegradable waste in this non-biodegradable dustbin. Now let's have a capture of threat. So when we are putting any type of biodegradable waste, you can see the message over there. Because of the presence of this biodegradable thing in this blue dustbin, it just ringed on and the LCD showed the message. Now when the garbages will reach onto the top of the dustbin, then it will send a message to MCU and MCU will send a message to GSM modem. GSM modem stands for Global System of Mobile Communication, which will transfer a message to the municipal corporation that this particular area the garbage has been filled, so that the corporation can come and take over the garbages in that particular area through the means of any transportation. Now moving on to the trash segregator. Trash segregator will segregate four type of waste, that is dry, wet, plastic and metallic waste. As we all know, due to this bad separation of wastages in the landfill, it is taking lot many days to separate, decompose and recycle. So this model will be helping to separate all the type of wastages in a proper manner. When we are putting any type of metallic waste in this blue dustbin, then it will be segregating the type of waste and accordingly it will get separated. And now if we are putting any type of plastic waste to this blue dustbin, then it will also segregate the type of waste and accordingly it will get deposited. Now moving on to this yellow bin, when a person will put any type of dry waste to this yellow bin, then it will also segregate the type of waste and accordingly it will get separated. Suppose I will also put any type of wet waste to this yellow bin, then again it will separate and go to the respective bin. So this will help the people of our country to separate and decompose the wastages in a proper manner. So this is all we have. Thank you.